हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द सेकंड लेक्चर ऑन द कोर्स मैट्रिक्स मेथड ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरल एनालिसिस। आई एम डॉक्टर ए एस अय्यर, वर्किंग एज अ प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, संजीवनी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, कोपरगांव। वी आर डीलिंग विद द फर्स्ट यूनिट ऑफ दिस कोर्स, दैट इज कंप्यूटेशनल टेक्निक्स, वेयर वी हैव टू लर्न द डिफरेंट न्यूमेरिकल मेथड्स used to solve the set of algebraic equation. In first lecture we have seen the first numerical method, that is Gauss elimination method, to solve the set of algebraic equation. Now in this lecture we will see the second method, that is Gauss-Jordan method, to solve the set of algebraic equation. The method is almost similar to Gauss elimination method. Only the change is, in Gauss elimination method we are converting the lower triangle of coefficient matrix into zero elements, but in Gauss-Jordan method we have to convert the coefficient matrix into normal form. Normal form means diagonal elements are 1 and remaining all elements are 0. Okay, so when you convert the coefficient matrix into normal form, we'll get directly the values of unknown variables in the set of algebraic equation, right? We will see the simple example, the example which we already solved by Gauss elimination method, the same problem we will solve by Gauss-Jordan method. Okay, so let's start. The problem is, solve the given set of equation using Gauss-Jordan method. Okay, so the first step is similar to Gauss elimination method. Write down given set of algebraic equation in matrix form. Matrix form, that is Ax is equal to b. A stands for coefficients matrix, that is coefficients of x1, x2, x3. So coefficient of x1, x2, x3 in first equation 2, 1, 4, that is 2, 1, 4, then 1 minus 3 minus 1, then 3 minus 2 plus 2. So like this, write down coefficients of x1, x2, x3, that is matrix A. Then vector x1, x2, x3 represent the vector of unknowns, that is vector x, and right hand side vector B represent the right hand side constants of the given set of equation. So very first step, write down given equations in the matrix form. Ax equal to b. Now second step, write down the augmented matrix. We know that in the first lecture we have seen how to write down the augmented matrix. Augmented matrix is a combination of matrix A and matrix B. So write down augmented matrix A comma B or A double colon B is equal to, first part of augmented matrix is a matrix A, and matrix B is a fourth column of the matrix A. So this is matrix A and matrix B, that is augmented matrix. Now we have to perform either row operations or column operations. Remember, we can perform only either row at a time or column operations. We cannot perform both the row and column operations at a time. So we have to decide first, either we have to go for row operations or column operations. Okay, so here we will go for row operations only. Our aim is to convert the matrix A into normal form, that is diagonal elements 1 and remaining all elements 0. Okay, so very first operation is interchange R1 with R2. We know that if first element is 1, it is simple to convert the remaining elements into 0. So very first operation is interchange R1 and R2. So if you interchange R1 and R2, R2 becomes R1 now and R1 becomes R2. That is first operation, interchange R1 and R2. Now to convert this element 0, select the operation R2 minus 2 times R1 and R3 minus 3 times R1. Okay, so if you select R2 minus 2 times R1, 2 minus 1 into 2, that is 0. 1 minus 3 into 2, minus 3 into 2, minus 6.
1 minus minus 6, 1 plus 6, that is 7. 4 minus minus 1 into 2, 4 minus minus 2, 4 plus 2, 6. Then 4 minus minus 5 into 2, 4 minus minus 10, 4 plus 10, 14. Similarly, R3 minus 3R1, 3 minus 1 into 3, 0. Then minus 2 minus minus 3 into 3, minus 2, plus 9, plus 7. Then 2 minus minus 1 into 3, 2 minus minus 3, 2 plus 3, that is 5. And minus 1 minus 5 into 3, 15. Minus 1 minus minus 15, minus 1 plus 15, the answer is plus 14. Okay? Now to convert this element 0. To convert this element 0, select the operation R3 minus R2. R3 minus R2. So first row as it is, second row as it is. Now in third row, 0 minus 0, 0. 7 minus 7, 0. 5 minus 6, minus 1. 14 minus 14, 0. Okay? So these three elements become 0. Now select the next operation, apply R2 plus 6R3, R2 plus 6R3. So first row as it is, now R2 will change, R2 plus 6R3, 0 plus 0, 0, 7 plus 0, 0, then 6 minus plus minus 1 into 6, 6 minus 6. It is 0. Then 14 minus plus 0 is 14. So second row will change, third row as it is. Now to make this element 1, diagonal element 1, divide R2 by 7. Divide R2 divided by 7. And to convert this minus 1 into plus 1, R3 is multiplied by minus 1. So first row as it is, second R2 divided by 7, 0, 7 upon 7 is 1, 0, 14 upon 7, it is 2. Then R3 into minus 1 means 0, 0, this minus 1 become plus 1 and 0. So all three diagonal elements becomes unity, 1. Now still two elements are remaining. Minus 3 and minus 1. These two elements we have to convert into 0. So next operation, apply R1 plus 3R2. R1 plus 3R2. So 1 plus 0, 1. Minus 3 plus 3 into R2 means 3 into 1. Minus 3 plus 3, 0. Minus 1 plus 0 is minus 1. Minus 5 plus 2 into 3, minus 5 plus 6, answer is plus 1. Last operation is minus 1, we have to make 0. So last operation is R1 plus R3, R1 plus R3, 1 plus 0, 1, 0 plus 0, 0, and minus 1 plus 1, R1 plus R3, minus 1 plus 1, it is 0. This is 0. Okay? Now if you look at this matrix A, matrix A is called as normal matrix. It is in normalized form. Normalized form means diagonal elements are 1 and remaining elements are 0. Now once you get the matrix A in normal form, the next step is now separately write down matrix A and matrix B. That is, this is matrix A into X, vector of unknown, and equal to, this is matrix B. Ax is equal to B. Now if you convert this into equation form, directly you will get the values of unknowns. x1 is equal to 1, x2 is equal to 2, and x3 is equal to 0. x1 1, x2 2, and x3 is equal to 0. Okay? So like this, you have to solve the set of algebraic equation using Gauss-Jordan method. Remember, to convert the
matrix A into normal form, we have to apply either row operation or column operation. We cannot perform both the operations together. Okay, so this is the second numerical method involved in unit number one, that is computational technique. Now there is only last third numerical method is remaining, that is called as Gauss-Seidel method. So that method we'll see in the next class. Okay, thank you very much.